Good afternoon, everyone. We are Team 3, and we have prepared our research topic on Starbucks Corporation. I myself introduced. My name is Rohan. She is Trupti, Yesha, and Yuja. As for the start of our research proposal, we have been allocated to different roles. Trupti was the chairman of our research project. Yesha was a diplomat. Yuja was technical support, and I was the recorder of my team. And I will be covering the part of results and discussion. Trupti will say the introduction, scope and aim and limitations part. Yesha will going to say about the investigation methods and the sources of data. And Yuja will finally conclude about the recommendations and conclusions. This is the acknowledgement, like we are sincerely thanks to Dr. Peter Meraliu for his continuous guidance, and he supported us and also gave a positive feedback, also a constructive one, to improve in our research report. And I will further hand over to Trupti to start the introduction part.
Thank you, Rohan. I said, Rohan, Starbucks Corporation is an American company, and which is situated, which is founded in 1971 in Seattle, Washington. As well as Starbucks is a public limited company, and which is operated by a restaurant brand in New Zealand. Our research project is conducted at a Starbucks 220 Queen Street, Auckland, and the specialties of the Starbucks coffees are the coffee, sweets, pastries, and coffee beans, and also sell coffees and other, and they also sell other coffee related accessories. Our main scope and aim is how to find effective solutions regarding miscommunication, and our group focus on the one element after our survey, that is in 220 Queen Street Starbucks phase 1 problems, that is miscommunication between employees and managers regarding wages and all that, and limitations. Our limitation is very hard to talk with that Starbucks employees during the peak hours, because that store is very busy during hours. As well as we tried to meet branch managers, but it took around a week because he was out of Auckland. That's why the group members have contributed specific times like 60 to 80 hours to fulfill that project. As well as next part, I hand over my teammate CSA.
Thank you, Trupti. This is the fishbone diagram we are used to solve our problem. So our main problem is miscommunication, and these four parts cover this problem. So first is the language problem, management problem, environment, and people. So a management problem is like employees get low wages and lack of training, because in the 220 Queen Street Starbucks, most of students are working there. So students feel like a manager can't provide like a motivation, yeah. So students feel this all the problems. Another one is lack of culture training, because most of people are coming from Asia, and in this Starbucks, most of employees are working in a Kiwi style. So the communication problem is also people face, and the management concept also used to solve this problem, and also organization behavior theory and system tools. All are the parts connected with our main miscommunication problem. Our sources of data is a primary data and secondary data. So primary data is like a questionnaire, in-depth interview, survey, feedback by customers, and also reviews from Facebook and Zomato. So the reviews by Facebook and Zomato is very important to cover our main problems. And the next part, it's depth review by Rohan.
Thank you, Yesha. As we can see over here, the results part, peak hours are like from morning 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. and evening 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So in the evening time, there are around 280 customers who are visiting approximately. As when we were doing our investigation methods and the questionnaire with the employees and the manager, so what we found from the basically the last 2 weeks data we have gathered, the number of customers who visits during the peak hours and who during around the minimal hours. So the as we can see over here, the data I have gathered over here. The another one is the satisfaction level of different customers. So as we can see, around 55% people are not satisfied with the service provided by the Starbucks, and 28% people are only satisfied because, as we can see, there are three branches in Auckland of the Starbucks. The one is in 220 Queen Street branch, another is in near 350 Queen Street branch, in front of Star City. So there are a lot of people who are coming nearby 220 Queen Street branch because there are many offices situated over there. So, as we can see a review from the Zomato website, the person has given for the environment 3 out of 5, drink quality quantity 4 out of 5, and for the service he has given 2 out of 5. So what he thinks is that the service they are providing is not very useful to the employees and the customers. So they feel little lack of, they are not communicating properly, or the customer relationship is not maintained properly. This is the another feedback given by the employee who was working there. As we can see, the former employee, he was the shift supervisor. So he was working at the Starbucks full time as less than a year. The positive point he has given, like the amazing culture, 5 days a week, shifts end on time. But what he say, the negative point, the slow growth, less salary increment, and no incentives in operation. So we can see the management level problems are facing by the employees in the Starbucks Main Street branch. So we have used the Edward D. Bono Six Thinking Hats to manage our solutions effectively. Like the blue hat process, our start process was from the research proposal to the end of the research report. We've conducted certain interviews and questionnaire with the employees. So at the starting of stage, it was a little bit difficult for us to manage the interview because as Trupti has said, the manager was not available, he was out of Auckland. And white hat, the facts and the key problem. The key problem is the miscommunication problem. And the roots of the miscommunication problem was basically the lack of culture training, motivation, low increment in wages. There we found this as the root problems. The feelings, the red hat defines the feelings of the employees. So at the time of the employee while he is working, so the pressures come from management level as well as from the customers. So the feelings changes time to time, from the stress, he becomes anxious, worried about the situation. The black hat cautions, as discussed earlier, the black hat means cautions we provided at our the problems, like this basically the low increment wages problem, also the communication barrier, which is the main important problem, as because the there are several students who are coming from Asia, like the India and China country, so they are not used to the Kiwi lifestyle, so they find it a little bit difficult about the communication problem. The yellow eye defines the benefits, like what benefits we can get after the, as we have used the organizational behavior theory and the six thinking acts as we can use over here. So the benefits we have introduced in the recommendations part, and the green eye defines the creativity and ideas. So what ideas we are going to get, what ideas we are providing, the alternatives and the best solutions. So the further part will be concluded by Yuja.
I'm Yuja. Thank you. So for the keyword, I would like to say this research is to identify the miscommunication between the employers and managers. We have introduced a field diagram to find the root cause of the miscommunication between employers and managers. For the data collection, we use four different methods to collect data. First one is a questionnaire. Second one is an in-depth interview. Thirdly, we search on the we look for the some relevant literature review, and finally we received some feedback from the customers. We use the Edward Thinking Hats to analyze the problem, and we use the black hats and gray hats is very useful for us. Yeah, for the recommendation, based on the research, we provided the list of the recommendation. Firstly, is pre-employment training section. Secondly, is motivating the employers. I want to especially to describe the motivate the employers. Certainly, the managers should give the employees the funny events, for example, like the ball game, to motivate the employer have the more motivated for the job. Thirdly, is increase their wage. Next is setting into the KV lifestyle. Finally, is the reward and appraisal system. Yet the manager should give the employers who working for 10 working for 10 around 40 hours, they should get a bonus. Yes, that's our presentation. Thank you.
Yep.
What kind of training session
you are talking about, right?
Yeah.
So the students who are coming from the different Asian countries, they basically they are not used to the Kiwi lifestyle, and they have the different accent and the communication skills are different. So at the initial stage, they found it a little bit difficult to get settled over here, as the customers who are coming in Starbucks, they are most of the people are the Kiwis, the European and the American people. So they find it a bit hard to communicate with them. So the manager should try a pre-employment training session so that he can see what improvement they should have in the communication barrier. So what their problem they are facing, how they can well communicate with the different customers. As the Asian people can easily communicate with their local languages people, so it will be difficult for them to communicate with the European people and Kiwis people. So the communication skills and how they can be improved, manager can have a training session on them.
Satisfaction.
Is that from the as you can see when you search on Zomato website, so if you type a name of a particular restaurant, so you will get the review about that particular restaurant only, not the overall. So when you can see the Starbucks of 220 Queen Street branch mainly, so the customer has given review about this one only, this particular branch, not the every branch of our brand.
Just because when we submitted
the research report,
yeah.
A week prior to that I found this data, as we were like, the sources of data, we were gathering the data, how we can add for our methodology. So while I was searching on Facebook and website, Zomato website, I found this data on the Zomato.
As you suggested, the review part is the major sources of data, right?
Review part are also the major sources of data.
But what I found is recent news, like lot of competitors, like suppose Starbucks competitor give the bad review, which exactly it's not applicable. It's just. Just a competitive market, just because So, do you think so? This is a proper source to collect the feedback, because it's just a competitive feedback which is given by
the. It's just a competitive feedback because there are, as I can say, there are Costa Coffee is there, McCafe, Starbucks. So these are you are trying to say these are the competitors for the Starbucks.
Yeah, and, suppose I'm from Barista, okay, coffee brand or Costa Coffee, okay? I wrote a review from the Starbucks, like Starbucks is not performing well, and because anybody can write, it's like a Wikipedia, you know. So that source is.
So as you can see over here, this guy is mentioning that he's been coming to Starbucks for over a decade. So he's coming to this particular branch, and he has given personal feedback. Not his employee from the other McCafe or you know the other coffee stores. So we cannot just say the competitors are giving the feedback. We can just see the person who is just coming to the regular coffee period to have a coffee over there. He is giving the feedback, and you can see that he is just giving the feedback a week ago over there, and he is having a lot of followers on the Zomato website. So he's a continuous blogger over there.
In my belief, in my opinion, I would rather trust the people, the customers sitting inside the coffee who just came out and had a coffee, rather than people who just said on the website, like, yeah, I went to coffee one day from 10 decades I'm going, and you know.
That's what I said. This is also the main source. We have also gave a questionnaire and a survey form for the customers who are visiting there. Yeah. So we have
our personal reviews.
Yeah.
We go there.
So what we have particularly focused on this photo is about the service they have been provided.
Proof is
And
so this is not really a major one.
Okay, we'll move on to this, other questions. But this is more just kind of like a symptom, and it reinforces the, it helps you go off and solicit feedback from customers, and this is confirming what you found in your formal customer survey. And the symptom hinted at here is the food is fine, the drink is fine, the service is low. But the issue is right. Is it a competitor who is filling up the review site with negative reviews, or is this an authority that you can take credibility from? We'll move on from that. He is obviously a reviewer, so he seems to do this for some reason. So then you've got to review the reviews of him. Why are people following him, and what do they think of his reviews? Are they following him because he is doing accurate reviews that people find valuable? This is how this modern digital age goes. So the questions and debate are very, very relevant. Let's move on to another topic of questions. I think we can take one more question. You had plenty of questions. Anyone else?
Which type of miscommunication you found between employees and product in your
research? Like the Starbucks coffee cafe over here is a particular busy cafe. So there is hardly any interaction between the manager and the employees over there. So what the employees are feeling, like the manager should communicate with them if they need any help. The manager should personally come to them and ask if you need any help, what else I can provide for you. And they should also help them regarding the service also. So if an employee is working there and he finds a problem, like customer is coming and he's just arguing with the employee. So what does the employee want? So managers want to come over here, help him, and wants to tackle the situation. So basically, there is no interaction between the employees and the manager. So because what the employees think is manager is not personally giving us, he's not giving the increment in our wages. And some of the employees who are working for more than 1 year, they have found like there has not been an increase in their wages. So this type of particular situation is causing a miscommunication problem.
Okay, thanks very much. Okay, areas of improvement.
Time consuming.
So you
may
be saying we are taking a lot of time for
Actually, one or two speakers had taken too much of time
right
to go in the flow, which was, it was going properly in the flow, but it just disrupted when the time was going over.
Uh-huh. Okay.
presentation slides should be in flow, because I saw one slide was pop up when you are speaking, then it is beeped, and also during the introduction when you are introducing the team, then it shows the acknowledgement.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
without the names.
Okay.
I think you heard there should be proper flow.
My feeling is that we gave you some feedback the other day, and that you didn't build on that feedback. We certainly saw the previous team built on the feedback they received. We mentioned the point about the second six hat slides. There was a lot of information given around that second six hat slides, and it's too much audio. You have to remember that some people are audio, some are visual, and some are tactile. You have to be addressing all three different ways of communicating. It needed images and pictures to reinforce what you were talking there. And we also gave you feedback about perhaps using that Johnson and Clark slide about factors related to motivation. You didn't take that suggestion on board, so it's a pity to have to repeat that. Other areas of improvement? No? Other good points? I think you were all very confident speakers. You in particular, you with speaking without the notes, very, very clearly, very well rehearsed, very well done there. Low reliance on notes and the slides. That was very, very good. And as you said, some very specific recommendations addressing initially a very broad issue, but narrowing down to some practical things. And nice to see the different sources of information that you used, data you used, to converge on the problem and the recommendations that you made. Any other points? Yeah?
A big difference for Yuja. The day when we saw you first, and you have come out really nice.
Yeah.
Good presentation.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.